One of my favorite parts of every new RPG that we sink our teeth into is having the discussion around what class should I play as a brand new player, because there's such a plethora of information to cycle through when you're trying to research what do I want to do for the first time. And in a game like Dragon's Dogma 2, where they have vocations and sub-vocations and a mixing of vocations and being able to change things on the fly, combined with the abilities that you can have, as well as the abilities of your pawns, it can sometimes feel a little overwhelming. But never fear, that's what we're here for, is to talk about things from the new player's perspective, the beginner's guide series that we do for every RPG that we're about to sink our teeth into. So welcome to the latest version. Today we're diving into what class should I play as a new player in Dragon's Dogma 2. Now, one of the coolest things is they've got a great series of posts up over on their website where we can start doing a little bit of preparation research to decide which vocation we want to play, which class that we're going to be able to sink our teeth into. The four basics that you can choose from, which are standard for most games, are going to be the fighter, the archer, the thief, and the mage. Now, this is slightly different from the first game where you had the fighter, the mage, and then a strider, which was a combination of thief and archer. And they've actually further separated out in Dragon's Dogma 2, where you're going to be able to have an archer straight from the get-go and a thief as a different character. So let's kind of break these down and go across. These are the four primary archetypes, primary vocations you're going to be able to get. And from here, you're going to be specializing into warrior, sorcerer, Magic Archer, and Mystic Spearhand. And there's two new ones, which are the Trickster and the Warfare. Actually, I think the Mystic Spearhand might be new here as well. I can't remember. The Trickster's new, and the Warfare is new as well. So, let's start with the Fighter. It says here the fighter vocation excels in melee combat, deftly wielding a sword and shield. So this is the big thing, sword and shield. If you want to be sword and board and you want to be the tank that protects your pawns from damage, you're going to want to stick to the fighter vocation from the beginning and carry that all the way through and just be the best that you can be with the sword. Now, pinging off of this, though, is the warrior, and the warrior is the two-handed variant. So it says here the warrior boasts a robust physique specializing in direct combat with strength to endure many enemy counterattacks, masters of two-handed weapons such as the greatsword and the hammer, and the strike that is unleashed after charging power into defining openings among the most powerful attacks of all vocations. So if you like doing big damage numbers with a melee weapon and you want to be up in the thick of it, up in the heart of the combat, on top of dragons like this right here, hitting them with your weapons, then you're going to want to roll a warrior, which is it's a subclass of the fighter. Then we can take a look at the archer, starting off specializing in bow attacks. Now, if you want to stick to the basic bow and the basic bow attacks, you just stick with archer all the way through. But if you want to specialize, which is what I'm going to be doing, I will be taking the magic archer vocation. This is what I plan on playing through the game for the first time as. And it is still an archer. It says here, available only to the Arisen, so you can't have pawns that are magic archers. The magic archer vocation excels in long-range combat with magical arrows. In addition to attacking or healing, they're also adept at supporting their allies and can learn a custom skill that unleashes a devastating attack over a wide area in exchange for reducing your own maximum HP. So it's an ultimate attack that has a pro and a con to it. So this is my preferred. I have also looked a little bit at the warfare, which we're going to take a peek at here in a minute. But if you really want to get into the nitty-gritty, I'm going to have a lot of fun playing this just because all the sparkles and arrows, and it looks really, really cool. So this is what I'm playing. I'm going to have more videos on the Magic Archer as we get closer to launch, as well as daily videos on Dragon's Dogma 2. So if all that sounds good to you, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Daily streams here and on Twitch. If you've been around for a while, you know all this stuff. There's a Discord. There's a Patreon. I play a lot of games. Check out all the playlists. Beyond this, we have the Thief. Now, the Thief, again, in the first game was sort of like the Strider that you could start off as, and you could do ranged and melee. But it looks here that in this game, in Dragon's Dogma 2, in the sequel, they are keeping thieves to two-handed stabbity stabs only. It says here they deal deadly speed, rapid and consecutive strikes with daggers in both hands while exhibiting outstanding mobility, quickly stepping away after striking, exploiting openings to cling onto enemies and inflicting heavy damage. They can also steal items from NPCs and enemies, which sounds like a heck of a lot of fun. I've traditionally in the past played Thieves in almost every game that I've ever played that are RPGs. And then over the last couple of years, like with Baldur's Gate 3 and Rogue Trader and some of the other games I've been playing, I've been sort of branching away from that thief archetype, and I've been exploring druids, more rangers, especially Beastmaster rangers I like a lot. So thief is something I might have played once upon a time, but these days I much more prefer the ranged attacks. Now, off of the thief, the warrior is the off of the fighter, the sorcerer is off of the mage, which covers him, and the magic archer there is the mystic spearhand. I don't know what the mystic spearhand. That's a specific to the Arisen, combines melee and magic, making them a well-balanced vacation effective from any range. A master of unique weapons, the duo spear, using magic they can paralyze enemies or hurl multiple objects at them. Now, if you've ever played Star Wars: The Old Republic and you watch this gameplay, I'm reminded. I think it's the Consular. Or the Shadow Jedi, which is a consular spec, I think, right? The Jedi Shadow Jedi, is that what it's called? They wield a two-handed lightsaber, and they do force attacks, and they can throw things, and throw rocks, and push mobs, and pull mobs, so they can use the force while using a two-handed lightsaber. And every time I see Mystic Spearhand videos, I'm reminded of that, and I am oh so tempted to go Mystic Spearhand, but I think I'm gonna have more fun with the Magic Archer. I could completely change my mind down the road. You never know. So that's why you want to stick around long term, because you never know what's gonna happen in my playthroughs. I don't know that the thief has anything that it turns into beyond the thief. But we do have the mage, and then breaking from the mage, we get the sorcerer. But the mage itself is a staff-wielding individual who has magic attacks. They do healing spells, and you can specialize in a lot of different ways. But if you really want to go damage, you're eventually going to want to spec into the sorcerer line. This is a completely, as they say, a vocation completely specialized in various magic attacks with both hands through a very large staff. And it says, as their magic spells take longer to cast, it's key for the sorcerer to find a safe place and determine the correct moment to strike. I can speak from having played one of these in Dragonstopper 1. Quick commercial break, everyone, to celebrate and give thanks to all of these amazing people who keep me on the air full time. Really appreciate the support. All you got to do is join as a member. You get access to private videos. You can also do super thanks on any upload or super chats and stickers on any live stream or premiere you see. And beyond that, don't forget we're multi-streaming over on Twitch now, so you can support over there as well. Thanks so much to everybody. Let's get back to the video at hand. Their spells take a long time to cast. And, placement is key, and it's really hard when you've got mobs that are highly mobile and moving all over the battlefield. So you really got to make sure that your tanks have aggro before you start doing stuff. Otherwise, everything comes for you, and it turns into a nightmare scenario. I originally thought I was going to play a sorcerer in the sequel, but then the more I've looked up on the Magic Archer, the more I've said, no, nah, I'm going to go Magic Archer. It just seems like the right thing for me personally. And then finally, we've got the Trickster and the Warfarer. Let's take a look at the Trickster yet. This is exclusive to the Arisen and exclusive to the second game. They conjure illusions through smoke created by a unique weapon called the Censer. They can use illusions to deceive enemies into fighting themselves and others of their ilk, and also have the ability to temporarily increase the power of pawns beyond their limits, which is really cool. And the Warfarer is one that also intrigues me a little bit, although I have a feeling it's going to be a little too complex for the way that I like to play, just because I'm old and my reflexes suck. The Warfarer is a new vocation exclusive to the Arisen, using every weapon in the game, learning different skills from each of the classes or each of the vocations, and by using these diverse arrays of weapons, they can create combos that cross the traditional vocational boundaries. They have a lower base stat value than all of the other vocations in the game, which utilizes the fact that they have all these situational strengths by being able to use any vocation on the fly. So there has to be a con against that pro. So this is something I would say that, in my perspective, the Warfarer is something that is definitely more suited to players who love Twitch-based gameplay, who are very fast on their reflexes, and they want to just get the most out of everything. With the con being you're going to have reduced stats. So for my money's worth, I think that the Magic Archer is the way that I'm probably going to go. I might be convinced to do Mystic Spearhand. You never know. The big thing for me is going to be getting hands-on in the intro when the game first launches and playing the early stages of each of those different types of vocations and figuring out what I think is going to be the best for me. But I'd love to hear from you. What do you think is going to be the best class for new players? What are you planning on playing for the first time? If you found this video useful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and the bell icon so you never miss an update as I continue to cover Dragon's Dogma 2 and all the other games that I do, so make sure to check out all the other playlists. I stream daily between here and Twitch. There's a Discord, a Patreon, and lots of other ways to connect. Check out the links below, and I'll see everybody in the next one. Stay safe. Happy gaming.